by acknowledging the land and our responsibility to care for and respect all that creation gives to provide us with life. This land upon which we live, work, and sustain ourselves is the ancestral and treaty lands of the Mississaugas and Anishinaabeg, also known today as the Mississaugas of the Credit, the rightful caretakers and title holders of this land. We also recognize that this land is rich in pre-contact history and relationships, which includes the Anishinaabeg and Ongahungwe, and since European contact has and continues to become home for Indigenous and non-Indigenous peoples. As a responsible community, we believe all people are sacred and possess inherent and immeasurable worth and dignity. Colonialism displaced and dispossessed Indigenous peoples of their ancestral lands and continues to deny their basic human rights, dignities, and freedoms. We are committed to the sacrament of reconciliation, making reparations and fulfilling our treaty obligations, duties, and responsibilities as outlined in the Gadonaganana Dish with One Spoon Wampum. This treaty governs and affirms that we actively maintain mutually beneficial relationships and collectively respect and care for the land, water, animals, and each other in order to guarantee a good life for our future descendants.
Good morning, Cardinal Ambrozic. Today is Friday, January 14th, and welcome to your morning announcements and prayers. You must be wondering, where am I? I got a couple emails from staff asking about my prayer space that was behind me in some of the videos, so I thought I'll show you. This is my own personal prayer space that I have at home, and this was started at the beginning of the pandemic when churches were closed and we couldn't go to our places of worship. But here at home, my family would come together and we would pray. Even me and my brother, we would pray a few times in front of this sacred space. This is my own sacred space, or what Father Vito would call this as a domestic church. Here we have some beautiful icon of the San Damiano cross, an icon of Our Lady throned. And I do have a prayer candle that is here just because the lectern, or my Bible stand, is usually placed here where the candle signifies the light of Christ coming from the written word. On my altar right now for today, and I usually change out what's on my altar depending on what is my prayer intention or what I want to pray for. And today I want to put on the altar Ms. Gomes as one of our staff members who is going through a hard time, but also all teachers. So right here on my altar I have a statue of St. John Bosco, who is one of the patrons of educators and who started an educational journey within Italy back during the Industrial Revolution. We have his mom, who accompanied him throughout everything that he did, and one of the students here with him. A lot of people suggest that this might be St. Dominic Savio, but it really represents all students together being educated, and this is just a symbol of education. Father Vito had given me this statue at the beginning of the pandemic when I was helping him a lot, but he talked to me about it representing part of my own educational journey, and I always light a candle in front of it to either pray for a teacher, but also to even pray for my own education as I go through. So this is just part of my sacred space. And I hope to share this with you and a little bit more as we go on. Maybe on Fridays, I'll film from the sacred space, and we'll have something new here to pray with and pray for. this morning, if you read the daily readings for the Mass, today's Gospel would be about the paralyzed. And it is the story of Jesus going home and everything being very, very busy. And it's so busy that no one really can enter the house. And there's this guy who couldn't walk. He was paralyzed and they wanted healing. So what they did was they opened up the roof because the roof was done out of almost like hay or planks of wood that they're able to move. So they opened that, the almost like a skylight. They moved it out and they lowered him in. And at that moment, Christ was forgiving sins, and people were talking bad about him, saying, "Who is he to forgive sins?" And knowing that, he then went to the man and told him, "I say to you, stand up, take your mat, and go home." And the person who was paralyzed, known to be paralyzed by the city, stood up, grabbed his mat, and went home. And people glorified God, as this is something that they haven't seen being done. So that was this morning's Gospel. And the reason why I'm sharing that with you is that sometimes we may feel paralyzed. Sometimes we may feel like we're stuck and that we cannot do anything, or we feel stuck in a issue or a problem. But there's always assistance that's going to help you. See, Christ never abandons us during those hard moments. He's there with you, experiencing those moments with you. And at times, he sends us someone to help carry our crosses. People who are in our inner circle, people who have assisted us through trials. There are so many people around you. We just need to take the time to recognize where is Christ in the people around us so that we're able to feel vulnerable and reach out for help when we need it. So this morning, as we end in prayer, please keep in mind Ms. Gomez and all those that are in hospital or those that are seeking medical care. We know that both nurses, doctors, healthcare workers, we know that caregivers are all being assisted by God, and we know that God is with them. And we pray that God continues to be in their hands as we pray our school prayers. We know that Christ is in all of us, and we become him here on earth as we do good deeds to those who are around us. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Christ has no body on earth but yours, no hands but yours, no feet but yours. Yours the feet in which he goes about doing good, and yours the hands in which he should bless us now. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Now, Ambrozic, here's your morning announcements. Again, I've said this yesterday, I've said this many times. Please remember that you are amazing, that you are smart, that you are intelligent, that you are beautiful, and you can do anything that you put your mind to. Take care, Ambrozic.
And now a message from Ms. Tardella. Course selection for the 2022-2023 school year is here. Your teachers have shared in their LMS the information we have provided for you to read over and consider when choosing your courses. On Friday, January 14th at 2:45, the Guidance Department will host a Google Meet for a questions and answer session. Please log into the Guidance Google Classroom for your grade and join the live session to find out more information and answer any of your questions. Thank you!
Hey CA, a quick announcement. This announcement is from Miss M. Interested in being a student trustee next year? The eligibility requirements are that you must be baptized Catholic and you must be enrolled in a grade 11 or 12 as of September 2022. And you must be able to attend all meetings at the school board level. Please contact Ms. M for more information by joining the Student Council Google Classroom. The code is HSCL2EV. Once again, that's HSCL2EV. Thank you, and please consider attending.
Thank you for your time. Have a great day. And Soron CA. God bless you all.